If you've got a PS5 and you're running out of storage for your games, then you can add up to another 8 terabytes of storage to your PS5. And Sony have made it really easy to do that, although there are some things that you need to be careful of when you do it. So in this video, we're going to cover all of that, and we'll also look at how you can use an external USB hard drive as well. Welcome to my tech gear. Let's get into it. So Sony lets you add more storage to your PS5 with an NVMe drive. Now that is a lot cheaper than Microsoft, which make you buy and use custom expansion cards for the Xbox Series X and S. However, not any NVMe drive will do. There are some minimum specs that you need to meet in order for that NVMe drive to work. Any NVMe drive that you use with your PS5 has to be PCIe Gen 4. The PS5 will also support only up to 8 terabytes of additional storage, and the read-write speed of that drive needs to be at least 5,500 megabits per second. Add on top of that the heatsink, because any drive should have a heatsink on top of it, and it needs to be a low profile heatsink. A lot of NVMe drives that you can buy for a PC have heatsinks on them, and some of them can be too big to fit inside a PS5. Generally, if you're in Amazon and you just typed in NVMe PS5 and it says works with PS5, generally that drive is okay. And you don't need to buy the most expensive car that you can find, just one that matches those specs. Because if we get onto prices, now I am using a Corsair MP600 Pro LPX that's here. Now, this wasn't the most expensive, but it also wasn't the cheapest either. So for the 2 terabyte card that I've got here, that one was $160. You can get it in a 1 terabyte model, and that's $80. You can get a 4 terabyte model, that's gonna cost you $290. There is actually an 8 terabyte version of this, which is ludicrously expensive and is $890. So that's the same across the board. If you get any NVMe drive that's 8 terabytes, it's going to cost a fortune. You can go to something like a Western Digital, like an SN850P. That's going to cost you about $350 for the 4 terabyte. So they are more expensive, and it will be slightly quicker than the Corsair MP600 that I've got here, but not enough that you're really gonna notice. So with all the specs and the prices out the way, let's just go install it in the PS5. So whether you've got a original PS5 or the PS5 Slim like I've got here, the steps are generally the same. Taking your PS5, make sure that the P is facing down on the table. Now on the back here, if you've got the original or the full face plate, you can just lift this corner up and then pull down and the cover comes off. For the Slim version that I've got here, all you need to do is pull on the back here and the top just simply comes off. Now here you'll be able to see the storage cover where the NVMe drive is going to go. So I just need to unscrew this screw up here. So that screw just comes out and then the cover just comes off. Right, so in here is where the drive goes. Now there is a screw right at the bottom here which you need to unscrew. So just undo this screw. So that takes that screw out that's there. Put that down, and then what also came out is this little grommet thing. So this little grommet thing that we took out needs to go into the size 80 hole that's in here. That's this 1, 2, 3, 4. It's the 4th hole along from here. Most cards that you get for the PS5 will be a 2280 card. Now you take your NVMe drive that you've got here, put it in at an angle, it will slot straight in, and just push that down, and it will sit nicely on top of where that grommet was. Now take the screw that we took out before, the smaller one, not the bigger one that we took out the top, and we simply screw that in place. Done. So here you can see how the low profile nature of the heatsink nicely fits inside this hole. Now we take the cover that we took off before, put it down there, and then we're gonna put this big screw back in at the top and screw it back up. There we go, nicely done up. Now we take our plate, our face plate, and we just simply snap that back into place. Done. Now let's plug this back in and get it working. So as soon as you start the PS5 up, the first thing it does is it detects the new drive that you've just installed and asks you to format it. And it will format the whole thing, so if there is any data on that drive, you are going to lose it. So let's just go to format hard drive. that's formatted the 2 terabytes, and it's got your read speed. It's detected it as 6,270 megabits per second. So that is easily more than enough of the minimum spec, which was 5,500. It does say that if you experience problems whilst playing a game installed on that storage, I should try installing it on the console storage instead. It is a little caveat that Sony puts into any third-party drive that's put into their PS5 to say, well, it might not work. Try and get out of jail card, really. But in reality, I haven't heard of any hard drive or any solid state drive when it's installed causing a problem, unless it's a slower read speed. So now we're into the PS5. Now, if we go into settings and go down to storage settings, so now you can see that you've got the 848 gig of the original console. So the PS Slim has, well, the PS5 Slim has a 1 terabyte storage to start with. Once you take the operating system into account, it only leaves you with 848 gig. On top of that, you've now got the M.2 SSD storage as well, which is picking up as an option. And it says you've got 2 terabytes of free space, because unlike the storage that's inside the PS5 that loses a fair bit of it to the operating system, any additional storage you add to a PS5 doesn't have that problem. So you get access to the full storage amount. So I've more than tripled the size of the storage inside my PS5, because it had 848 to start with, and now I've got an extra 2 terabytes on top of that. You can also change the install location. So the default install location for your games and your apps, for your PS5, it's set to console storage. And then if you want to change it to by default install to the new drive that you just installed, you can click on M.2 SSD storage as well, or instead. And you can do the same for your PS4 games if you have any of those that you want to install as well. Now, it does have an option for USB extended storage, which I don't have. And that was the one thing I said that we were going to talk about, because that is an external USB drive, which you can plug into the PS5 and you can install PS5 games on that external drive. However, you can't play PS5 games on that external storage, mainly because it's just too slow. In order to play it, you would have to move it back to your internal storage or the drive that we just installed. The advantage of that is you don't have to keep installing or keep re-downloading games and reinstalling them all the time. You can just move them around. So that's a good option if you've got a lot of games and you just want to put the less frequently played ones on an external storage. You can, however, play any PS4 games that you've got on the external drive on that PS5 without having to move it. So that's how you add more storage to a PS5. If you've enjoyed the video, please let me know in the comments down below. Consider subscribing if you're not. And as always, I'll see you in the next one.